everyone. Welcome to another edition of the Brief Talk Podcast. We have a brief tale to you today from someone who made me extremely excited when I asked them to be on the show, because he already listens to the show unbeknownst to me. And I got all excited because I didn't have to explain the podcast. Welcome to Jay. Welcome.
Thanks, Sam.
Thank you for coming on.
I'm so excited I got to put a smile on your face.
It was just like, what, you listen? Wait a minute. Back up. You listen to the podcast? You know about the podcast?
I'm a fan, yes.
So I'm very excited when he said that and listens. And so it's like, yay, I don't have to explain much. You know all about it. And I'll just send you the questions. Yay.
Yep, I know the 411 on it. So
we have him here. He has an amazing Instagram account, because I told him beforehand I loved his socks that he wears with his briefs, and you look really good in them. So
thank you.
I was very excited when you said yes, and I was like, oh, what? I was expecting the I don't know what a podcast is, and no.
No. Are you serious?
Many people say no, so it's like, I don't know if it's my thing. So when you said yes, I was like, awesome.
So I was not about to reject you.
So yay, unlike many of my dates, but yay, that's a different story. So let's go. Let's just jump into our podcast. So first off, tell, if our listeners aren't familiar with who you are on social media or follow you, tell them a little bit about you.
And I am sure they're not. So my name is Jay. I live in New York. I am creative director, and I have an obsession for underwear.
Well, the last one is very much a good thing to be on the podcast, because we all do. And you look very good in it. So
thank you. I try. I think that's the motivating factor, is working out so that I can look good in whatever I'm wearing, especially underwear, even if it's for myself. Because I, you know, like everybody else, we have that critical voice in our heads. And for me, being a designer, it's all about balance. And I kind of end up applying those same concepts when I'm looking in the mirror, which is a headache. And I hate how my brain works, but so luckily, for good or for bad, underwear is what really keeps me fit and trying to keep going to the gym.
Well, I will say, I don't know where I saw your picture when I was scrolling Instagram. I don't know if I already followed you or didn't. I follow so many people, I do not know. And then I came across your picture, and I'm like, stop. Wait a minute. Who is this? Okay, let me look. Let me look at your profile. Okay. Because every so often you get those guys who post the random picture in underwear, and it's like, oh, or they post like a swim brief picture, and you're like, okay, you go look at their account and there's nothing there, and you're like, oh, okay.
Yeah, probably total teases.
But yours was like, ooh. Okay, I need to ask this person to come on. And that's how it happened.
So. Yeah, I started posting again after like a year off. It was very interesting to get, you know, a couple messages from people saying, oh, you're back again. Back again in terms of the content I used to put out there years ago.
Well, you can take a break when you need to. And social media is not always the best place in the world. But, you know, sometimes social media is work, and you just want to have fun with it. And, you know, if you get caught up in it, you can be like, oh, I got to take a picture today. I got to do this. I got to post. And I got to, it's not fun. So you want it to be fun and have good time with it. And then when it becomes work, you're just like, oh, I'm done.
True. You want to keep that spontaneity, right?
Exactly. So let's jump in there and say, so what was your first discovery of underwear? What was it that made you go, what is this? And why don't I own this?
Well, I would say it's two phases or two points in my life. The first one was probably when I was around 3 to 4 years old. My mom had a Sears catalog. And I remember my brother and I we're in the living room flipping through this humongous, like, 1,000-page catalog. And we got to, I think, the women's section first, and my brother was just having a meltdown. He was just completely enthralled. And we kept going through the pages until we got to the guys. And that was my bingo moment. And then everything else after that is kind of a blur. I don't remember really gravitating towards underwear until I moved to Atlanta. My mom remarried. We moved to Atlanta. I must have been around 8. And seeing three of my stepbrothers who were in their 20s lived with us. And I was sharing rooms with one of them. And I would see them in their underwear. And that's when I discovered, you know, 80s style crazy prints and briefs. Mm-hmm. And I think they call them muscle briefs or string bikinis or, sports briefs. So that was really my discovery. And after that, it was in my world, and it quickly became something that I gravitated towards.
Nice. That's a good way to discover underwear. The 80s were the high time of the underwear world, with bikinis and crazy prints and all the fun things that we're finally getting again that we missed in like the early 2000s. So yes, I remember the 80s well. I miss them.
So amen to that. Yeah. And also the materials and the packaging and the ads. I think there was just a little bit more enthusiasm and being the States and, you know, having this mindset that we talked about earlier, where it's a little bit puritanical. Then the 80s and the very early 90s were like a flourishing moment in that. And it was kind of sad after like 94, 95, things started kind of going down. And so the last couple of years, probably since 2006, but mostly like 2010s, I've noticed that things have really changed for the good. So that's exciting.
We are seeing more underwear being sold, more swim briefs being sold. So it's becoming much more wear what you want to. We're not there yet, but we are getting there, I will say, because you know, if it was up to us, we would have everyone in bikinis and jocks and thongs, and the rest of the world would be like, what are you wearing? Oh my God. Our society would go crazy over that. So yes.
Yeah. And I think the other thing that has changed that really is something that even when I was younger, I wished for was underwear that actually fits. Like there was, because back in the day, everything was flat in the front, right? And one thing that I remember clearly is that most American companies, when they made their underwear, even Calvin Klein, for example, they used to be a lot longer vertically. So when you put them on, they went over your waist and then you'd get a wedgie in the back.
Yes. Yes.
So that's one thing
they were
that
higher-waisted, yes.
Yes. Yes. So that was always a nightmare for me. Even when I gravitated to that kind of style, the fit was never truly perfect. And I think the one brand that I discovered that really nailed that was Next to Nothing in 2006, 2007.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And that was, that was a game changer for sure. So kudos to Andrew.
Andrew's one of my favorite people in the entire world. yes. But no, Andrew makes some of the most amazing gear, especially if you want to show off and show off the male form. He has always done it. I was looking through the sale today, and I will say his bikers are like one of the few boxer briefs I like because of the pouch. And there is like, you're showing it all off in this, no matter what you're doing. And Andrew love that man. And I'm like, and if he doesn't stop making singlets, I'm going to kill him.
I know. Right. And he probably won't.
He won't. So, he laughs every time I send him a message. I'm like, stop doing singlets. And he'll just send me a message laughing back at me. He's like, sorry, the boys want them. And I'm like, duh, I know the boys want them. Yeah, I'm one of the boys who wants them, so stop it. That's my money you're spending.
One of the things that I haven't been able to conquer is wearing his ties at the gym. Like, I can wear any other tights, but those, I think I would probably get thrown out. Because even now, you'll get, you know, people looking at you, which is fine. But those, I think those would be, like, illegal.
Well, the only place I've seen people wear them has either been a really gay gym.
WeHo. In WeHo. People go to the grocery store in them, I'm sure.
And, like, you know, like, the sex club that have the gym in it. Like, in, what is it, Chicago, they have the gym in it? Steamworks or something?
Steamworks, right. Yeah.
Has the gym, and you can wear either nothing or something and like that. But I just, like...
That is hot.
Yeah. You can't really wear those. It's like, he makes them you could wear that are more flat front and not so bulge-tastic. But there are some, it's just like, oh, lordy. Yeah. I love these, but oh, no.
Even the flat ones, though, even the flat ones, there's something about the way he does them. And I think it's because also, that's one of the things that I applied when I had my brand, was making sure that, especially tights, don't go over your waist, because most people tend to roll them, right? Roll them down, which I always find annoying. So when I had my line, I made them to the waist. Almost like, you know, what Andrew did. So I noticed that that's what keeps me from wearing them at the gym, because sometimes I'll do something and they will go way down. And then there's a lot more being revealed, which, again, could get me kicked out of the gym.
Well, depending on what gym you're at.
Right, exactly.
Make it your new workout partner. I'm just saying.
Thank you for the tip.
So, are people to spot you? They'll be like, could you spot me?
Right? I should.
Turn in, you hear that music start to play in the background. Yeah.
That's a good way to test who's straight, gay, or, you know, willing
or questioning,
to.
Or questioning. Yeah.
A little confused and willing to, you know, jump on this bandwagon.
I'm just, you know, I thought the Q and this thing was for queer, but they tell me it's questioning. I'm like, oh, okay, whatever. I'm not questioning your questioning. So, do you remember the first good pair of underwear you got?
Yes, I do. I do. It wasn't mine. It was my stepbrother's. He had recently been on a trip to London, and when he got back, he brought back a bunch of things that he bought, and within that shopping spree that he had, that he did, was a pair of pink home sport briefs or string bikinis.
I do love
it. And yes, and though I've bought some things from H&M, it's not what it used to be.
No.
So it's changed, but I had never seen like craftsmanship the way I did. And granted, I was like around 8 or 9. But I was, you know, again, as a designer, I gravitate towards colors and materials and textures and packaging. So I remember just everything about it was amazing. And for whatever reason, he just threw them away. And I picked them up, washed them, and they became my favorite pair. And they fit me perfectly. But yeah, that was the first pair. It was pink, and it had these very light horizontal blue lines. And I think that's where my love of pink underwear came from. Was that pair? Yep.
Nice. No, I know pink is very popular with boys of all sexual orientations. When you have a pink pair, it sells out almost instantly.
It does,
As you know, if Andrew comes out with anything pink at end to end.
Which is rare.
It's rare, it's but rare when he does... Is. It's gone.
It's in my cart.
It's soon as that email, I will give everyone a tip now that I bought the one thing I needed from him this year, which was the Flamingo swim brief with the buckle. I missed the one last year.
Those were hot.
So I bought the one this year. Saturday morning, get up early, East Coast, get up 7 and 8 a.m. That's when it goes live. So the email goes out right when it goes live too. So if you get the email Saturday morning...
I don't get the email, but I've noticed that he does post things go live like on Thursday night sometimes, like at midnight. I'm kind of a night owl, so if I have nothing to do, I'll go into the website, which is dangerous. Yes. But yeah, I noticed that it might not be publicized, but if you go down to the menu and you scroll down, sometimes it's there, like the actual tab for the new collections is there. So
So
little tricks ahead. we got to do, right?
How you get ahead with it. And people are like, yeah, but you know, Andrew, you can get stuff. I'm like, bitch, no, I can't, because I've already tried that, because he'll get something, sell out. And I'm like, because he had the Mercury singlet 2 years ago. It was black, sort of had little holes in it, so it's sort of meshy.
Oh, I have that.
And it was like, so I did not get the black. I have every color but the black. I've missed the black 2 times, because as soon as I got the email the second time, I went to buy it, and it was sold out in my size. And I'm just like, and I'm asking Andrew, do you have this in extra large? Please tell me you have one. He's like, nope. I'm like, I'm like, Andrew, you let me down.
Remind me, he's been on your podcast, hasn't he?
He's been on our podcast many times.
Okay, great. So because he's been on your podcast, I think that warrants a hookup. Like, he needs to maybe send you a little message beforehand, you know, letting you know, like.
He knows now that if it's something like that, I'm like, you better send this to me or do something. And then every so often I'll buy something and I'm like, I just bought this. And he's like, well, why didn't you let me know? I'd send it to you. And I'm like, because I wanted it now. And I believe in supporting my underwear company. Right? I said, I do appreciate every so often, but you know, I support you as well. So, you know, and you can't always send me everything I want, because I would be emailing you every week.
Yeah.
Ian, can you send me this? Can you send me this? Can you send me this?
And I've also noticed that, like, his stuff, well, I think just every brand out there, but mostly his stuff is, like, so limited now.
Yes.
I don't know if he just only makes 20 of each, but it's like, you got to jump on it. Like, sometimes, you know, back in the day, you could wait till the sale came in, which is, like, months later, right?
He did one collection a year. One collection a year.
And you could wait till December when the sales came out, and you could buy everything for, like, you know, reduced price, but... meaning that those items were available throughout the whole year. Now it's like, you've got to grab it, because in like 2 days it's gone.
Oh yeah.
He's introduced underwear anxiety. Thank you, Andrew.
Yes. He anxiety and frustration, I call it, because if you miss it, you're like, son of, cause at first Flamingo pair, I didn't buy, and it went on sale. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, oh, this is meant to be. I get this pair. I forgot about it until I got this email. And I went and looked, and they were sold out of my size. And I'm like, Andrew, don't you have any? He's like, nope. And I'm like, son of a bitch. I'm like, oh. But yeah. So pink.
So now that you have it, I'm...
What's that?
Pink is... I was going to say, so now that you've got the Flamingo swim brief that you were so craving, do you wear it now all the time? If I went to Atlanta, would I see you, like, washing your car outside wearing it?
I should, because I don't have access to a pool or anything. And because you know how Atlanta is, you lived here. We're not near water, so you have to have nose with the pool or something. And
oh, that's excuses. It's hot. It's humid. Hot. And there's grass to cut. There's always grass to cut in Atlanta. Perfect.
My neighbor would not know.
No.
What
a shame.
No, that would be, I don't live in the gay section of town. If not, they'd probably be like, yes, please. Now it's like, there are families here. And I'm like, ugh. But moving on. So you got the pink pair as your first pair, which is amazing. You were the first person I heard who got pink, which is still the hottest color in men's underwear. I don't care what anyone says.
It is. Absolutely love it.
So you got this pink pair, and then you're, of course, very young and probably did not have your own money and a way to buy new underwear. So when did your underwear start kicking in, where you started to buy what you wanted and you started to get what you found amazing and sexy and fun?
Oh, I was going to say college, but no, maybe one pair or two once in a blue moon, because obviously I was in college and sort of cash poor. I think once I was like 5 years into my career, especially, I think my collection's especially gone, you know, beyond my imagination since I moved to New York. It's like quadrupled, and I'm just being, you know, lightly saying quadruple. I think it's more than that. Nothing it is out of control.
Only the adulting part of spending money you're not supposed to spend is out of control, but the rest I fully support. True. Because everyone needs fun stuff. Everyone needs to feel sexy. Yeah. Everyone. And this is the way we do it. Underwear is one of the best ways to do it. And when I was telling you earlier, I have a surprise coming later this year. Someone I was talking to, I told you beforehand, who's starting a company. And he was amazed at this whole thing about guys and sexy underwear and all this stuff. So it was like, he's like, what? He was blown away. And I'm just like, yeah, confidence. And so he's like, and people just buy. I'm like, you would not believe how much how many boys spend on underwear. And I'm just going, yeah.
Amazing.
It's lovely and amazing. So,
I mean, I think it says a lot about the person, you know, and, whatever you choose to wear. And then he says, you know, how you see yourself or how you want the, you know, your partners to see you, what kind of state of mind you're in. So I think it's important.
And never deal with the ones who ask you, what are you wearing?
I don't think I've ever. Well, when we talked earlier, I did tell you when I started first wearing the fashion, as they used to call them, fashion jocks, back in 2006. And even my gay friends thought that my underwear was ripped in the back because they had never really seen those before. So that was fascinating. But yeah, no. Other than that, I've never had a partner say that to me.
I have. And they were not my partner for much longer.
How dare they? Right? Immediately out the door. Like,
now I just don't even. This was one I had for a while. Yeah. And now it's like, sorry, you got to go. Bye.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's interesting with underwear and partners and navigating that, but we'll get to that. That's further down in the questions.
Okay.
We'll get there because you have a partner.
Well, you know, even for me, you know, everyone has certain types that you're attracted to, but for me, even a guy that wouldn't normally be my type, if I see that he cares about what he's wearing, you know, the style of underwear or the shoes or whatever, that's also a big turn on.
Mm-hmm. Well, in another podcast you'll hear before this one, I brought up the point that, especially in Atlanta, I don't know if we said it after or during the podcast, I don't remember. The boys here, you know, they spend $300 on jeans, but yet they wear boxers underneath. And I'm going, you spent $300 on your jeans, you spent $100 and something on your shirt, you spent like $400 on your shoes, another $200 on your belt. And you're wearing that underwear.
You know, the 5-pack of Walmart underwear for $9.99.
It's just like, oh, boys.
Could they have run out of money? Makes you wonder.
The credit card couldn't get the Versace underwear, I guess.
Right.
Because you expect even Versace those under all that.
Those are ill-fitting.
Well, I've noticed on social media.
It's a waistband.
The boys are wearing the hell out of Versace underwear. Every time I turn around, it's that band. I see it everywhere. And I look at the price and I go, I could not spend $75 for a jock. I'm sorry. I don't care if it's Versace. No.
Well, I think it started with a Calvin Klein, right? In the 90s with a waistband. And then it gravitated towards Tommy Hilfiger, which makes me cringe. But when I lived in Atlanta, Tommy Hilfiger waistbands was everything.
Oh, yeah. It's amazing. Well, then we...
So at least the waistband now is nicer to look at.
So, well, then you have the boys who like waistbands who don't, which is a show idea that I have that I haven't done yet. But yeah, that's a whole different story. That's a whole different podcast. It's waistbands. I, of course, am a waistband fan and other people I know are not. But
they can be hot. You know, I have these shorts and this jock that has this really wide waistband and it pops out of my shorts when I'm usually wearing a crop top at the gym. And those can definitely be head turners for sure. Wow. It's a look, I guess.
See,
I stumbled it by mistake.
We need a picture of this look.
Just saying, it's in my Instagram.
Oh, it's on the Instagram. I will dig through the
Instagram. How dare you?
I've ducked through, but not obviously that well.
Not in fine detail with a magnifying glass.
I didn't zoom in on every picture yet. Just give me the rest of the weekend and I'll have it done. So yes, I will have it done. So you moved on from these wonderful underwear, and now you have this massive collection. Yeah. What are your favorite styles and brands right now that you love?
At the moment, Charlie. I love Charlie, and it's breaking the bank. And the reason why I like them, they don't have a huge pouch, but it's the way that they're cut and the material. Mm-hmm. The sizing is always consistent throughout every pair. Also, Next to Nothing. I love Next to Nothing, but sometimes their sizing can be a little off, which I understand. I mean, it's not perfect. When I had my own brand, it's like no matter how great you are at quality control, something's going to happen. Someone always messes up. So, but I still love love his stuff, especially the new micro underwear, micro briefs that he's released in the last year. Obsessed with those. Then Greg Holm. I love Greg Holm. I love Greg Holm. That's another one that breaks the bank.
The one good thing about Greg Holm, though, is A, it's super sexy. It's super fun. B, it's usually really good materials it's made out of. And C, it holds up for a lot longer than a lot of the pairs. The only one that I had trouble with is I had, when they did the modal line with the matching robe, they had the bikini
blue. Yeah. I didn't get that one, but I remember it.
I got both, and the bikini got a hole in the bottom. Of course, it's been, I've had it for like almost 10 years, so it's not like I'm like, it just fell apart. No, it lasted a long time, but it still makes me cry because I'm like, I love this bikini. I'm like, damn it.
So there was no way to repair it?
No, where it is. And I'm just like, so I was upset about that. I was just like, but it lasted a good 7-8 years solid. And I wore it a lot. So I'm like, I'm not really upset over it, but it's so good.
But you still are.
I'm upset, but I'm like, it's a lot of brands you don't get that from. You get like maybe a year and it's like, okay, it's done. But this is many, 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 many years. So I'm like,
Well, I've got a pair. I've got two pairs of jockey sport briefs, string bikinis, whatever you call them, from the 90s, from 1991. And I wore one of the pairs to a 90s party that my friend threw. And so when I got there, people were asking like, you know, so what's your 90s gear? I mean, I don't see you wearing anything 90s. So I'd like had to show them. And most of them kind of cringe, thinking that it was like, oh, it's a pair from like 30 years ago. It must be disgusting and dirty. But the thing is, I have so much underwear that I probably wear, you know, each pair like twice a year. Mm-hmm. So they never get a full usage. So I can like have pairs from like 20, 30 years ago. But I do. Yeah, they're fantastic.
I have a thong jockey made in the 90s. That I just love. It came in black and red. I know I still have the black. I don't know if I still have the red. And it was this most amazing thong. And of course now it's way too small. But I just refuse to get rid of it because I used to wear it. And I have so many pairs that I love. Which I'm like, no, I'm not getting rid of this. And I'm like, this is
frame out.
You made good underwear, fun stuff.
Yeah.
But yeah,
they did. What happened? What a shame.
It's jockey went from, like I said, the era of Jim Palmer and bikinis to, you know, this past 2 or 3 years ago, making fun of their thongs.
Yeah.
Because you had the country star who was like, she was like, this is your new pair. And it was like her thong. And he's like, oh, I'm not wearing that or something. It was just like,
I haven't seen it.
Come on. It was a couple years ago. So it was like, get over it, Jackie. But yeah, it's amazing what happened back then, and now we're slowly coming back to it. Not fast enough, but we're slowly coming back. So,
quickly going back to your previous question, the last brand that I've recently discovered that I really love is Olaf Benz from Germany.
Oh, yeah, from Germany.
Their stuff is amazing, especially their what they call Brazilian briefs.
Yep.
They fit perfectly. Every single pair I've gotten, and I've gotten too many, great. And it's very much a la Greg Home, but the problem with Greg Home is the tags in the back are really cheap and hard, and sometimes it will damage the material if it's very thin. Yes. And another thing is the way Greg Home cuts their briefs from the back to the sides is not ideal. And I have a couple pairs, and I think they're comfortable, but aesthetically, they don't look great. And so what I like about Olaf Benz is that they've managed to really frame your butt as it goes to the curves and to the front. So, yeah, that's why I'm a big fan. So I think people should try them out.
I have something to tell you when we get down to the podcast, so remind me. And no, people, you cannot hear what I'm going to say, because that's the part about coming down the podcast is you get some extra dirt behind the scenes that you're not going to get.
Ooh.
And no, you cannot pay me to get the dirt. So, well, you can, but you got to pay me. Go join Patreon and get us way up there. Because we had someone who wanted sexual fantasies or something. And I'm like, well, if you want that, you got to pay a lot. I'm just not giving that for free. Sorry, boo. If you know me, you'll get that free of charge. But if you want on the podcast, you got to pay. Nothing is free. Thank you.
Nope.
So we talked a little bit about your friends and your underwear,
mm-hmm.
and you have a partner who I've seen in your Instagram.
I do.
And what does your partner think of your underwear? And what was his reaction when you first got together? Was it like, oh, this is different or cute? Or
I think he just kept seeing each time that my pants would come off. He just kept seeing like all these different styles and colors and prints, and it was just never ending. So it's like, oh, a new one. So that was kind of his reaction. He's really open-minded. So I think he would support me if I actually told him I have an obsession. I think he knows. I don't really talk about it. I just let him see it when the pants come off. And one thing about me too is like, every guy that I've been in a relationship with, I always end up buying them underwear. So with him, I've done the same. But I don't go towards things that I know he might not wear, like thongs, for example, or briefs with pouches, just because that's not something that he gravitates towards or feels comfortable in. But no, he's supportive. He's seen me in like really tiny, what they call muscle briefs at the beach now. So, so he just looks at the waistband, kind of like pulls it and just like kind of rolls his eyes, and that's it. That's as far as it goes.
But at least you're expanding his horizon and getting him.
I think so.
What he likes, and not being like, here, wear this like super pink G-string. That's so not you, but you know, wear something that's you, but a little bit better. So you both get out of it.
Absolutely. And I think he knows the thongs are coming out to the beach next year, because I'm slowly gravitating towards that.
I say do it. Do it.
Yeah.
If you can. Wear what you want to, and more boys are wearing them, and it's a whole
thing. Well, I think the one thing about getting, I hate using the word older, but the one great thing about getting older is that you stop giving a shit about, oops, can I curse?
you can curse. We have explicit warning, so you're good.
Oh, great. You don't care about what people think anymore. At least I don't, especially in the last 4 years since I've been in New York. Like, I really just don't care what people think. I think the only thing that I care about is if I see a reflection in the mirror and I don't look good in something, then that's the voice that I care about the most. So that's why I haven't gravitated towards like thongs at the pool or at the beach yet, because though I work out, I've always been my harshest critic when it comes to my butt.
Mm-hmm.
So, but like I said, at this point, I'm just starting to like not really care anymore. And like we talked about earlier, you know, time is ticking. And if you don't really enjoy things now, when you're like, 80 and your butt's hanging all the way down to your knees, then you're going to regret not doing it. So, yeah, so next year.
It's true, though, because when you think when you were younger, because I was like real thin, total Twinkie, thought I would look horrible. And you look at pictures and you go, damn, I was hot back then. Why didn't I know I was hot back then? Now exactly. That I'm older, you're like, damn it. Well, I did wear everything like bikinis and crazy stuff. So I wore that. So I at least have that part to go with. But I never thought I was all that and hot. And then you see the pictures and you're like, you know, I was a big old dork, but I was a cute dork back then. So
that's true. So, that's the way it works, unfortunately.
And now it's like, fuck it, I'm wearing what I want to. Good for me.
So, amen to that. Yep.
It's crazy and wonderful. And partners, it sounds like you have a good partner there, which is awesome because so many partners don't get it, don't understand it, and look at their partners like, what are you wearing? What is that? Is that women's underwear? You have to have a good partner, and underwear is a part of our lives, and they have to accept it, and they may not get it, but at least they accept it and go with it. So no one I have ever dated has gotten underwear. It's always been kind of like, oh, what are you wearing? Oh, yes. Only the once, was it once or twice, was it the, oh, what are you wearing? But most are like, oh, oh. And kind of like you, where I came in different pairs, and they're like,
yeah.
How many do you have? And I'm like, a lot. And I enjoyed them. Thank you very much.
Maybe secretly they really enjoyed it. They were just hesitant to.
I've had bring it more up. Enjoy it on me than on them. They, my longest term ex, he definitely enjoyed it on me, but he did not partake in it. So,
yeah. So, hey, as long as there's some enjoying going on, that's really all that matters, right?
That's all that matters, as long as you enjoy it and it's all good. So,
yeah.
So you and your partner, you like swim briefs and whatnot. You wear them to the beach.
I do. He wears swim briefs. I wear smaller cuts.
Yes.
Two reasons why I do it. One is because I feel like it's more comfortable for me, but also I'm not very tall. So if underwear or swim stuff is like really big on the sides, it looks kind of weird on me. It just, again, going back to the graphic designer brain of mine, it doesn't feel balanced. So the only way that I feel like a pair of underwear or swim attire looks good on me, if the cut is smaller on the sides, then my proportions look better. So that's why I kind of gravitate towards that.
Yes, I did see the pictures of you together in the swim briefs, and I was like, oh, he's got his man wearing it. I was like, good for him.
Yeah.
Good for him.
Yeah. And I was wearing a big pair that day, which is out of character.
Well, you can, it's your prerogative. You can wear what you want. Because you probably did it to make him a little more comfortable and get him in them. And
I think I did it to throw people off too. All my friends, when we went to the beach, part of me wanted to do it just because I don't normally wear it. And because it's a really nice pair that I got from Charlie. So it's like, it's got to be worn at some point. So it was for multiple reasons.
Well, it doesn't really matter. You still wore them. So that's all that matters. So how does underwear boost your confidence, either, you know, in work life or sexy time life, or, you know, how does underwear really boost your confidence when you wear it?
Well, I think what it does for me is that when it keeps me motivated to try to look my best, especially in winter, when I have no desire to go to the gym and I want to hibernate and get fat. It's one of those things that I have to constantly wear. So it's a constant reminder to, you know, try to stay fit. The other thing is, depending on the season, underwear makes me really comfortable and makes me feel more at ease throughout my day, because I have different pairs for depending on the weather or depending on work or depending on gym, because not all underwear is made for the same activity. I mean, I guess you could wear cotton underwear for everything, but it's really uncomfortable for, you know, for like working out.
I was about to say, why would you?
Or for the summer. Yeah, why would you? That was a very extreme example. So depending on what I'm wearing and depending on what the weather is, it will help me feel more comfortable. And feeling comfortable also gives you that extra umph in your day to, you know, tackle whatever it is that you need to tackle, especially with me when I have to present to clients. I've got to feel very comfortable in what I'm wearing. So having something that fits really good on me and knowing that it looks good on me is also that boost that I need to just feel a little bit more confident and just my everyday interactions. And even with myself, when I'm passing through a mirror, I want to make sure that, you know, I'm comfortable with the reflection that I'm seeing.
I would be if I were you, but that's just me. I'm going through the Instagram even more when we get done. So yes, I will dig through it. Cause I told you, I love the socks that you wear with them. Cause I'm a sock and underwear kind of guy. If I can match my socks and underwear, I'm extremely happy. And if I can match my sneakers even more so happy.
Amazing. Yes.
But
that's hard.
Underwear and sneakers are very expensive, and sneakers even more so. So it's kind of like sneakers are not the top priority. Because I'm sure you remember this picture. It was a Greg Home picture where he was wearing the pink, I think it was a jock brief. And he had the matching pink sneakers on.
Yes, I do. I think I have that picture saved in my external hard drive somewhere.
If you don't, I have plenty I can send to
you. Oh, you do? Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that was.
And when amazing. I met with him in Vegas, when I used to go, and the salesperson, I said, oh, my God, this picture is going to sell this underwear. And Eric, who designs it, goes, what are you talking about? I was like, sneaker and underwear matches. I was like, do you understand how the boys are going to lose their mind over this picture? Because I'm losing my mind over this picture.
There's something about the combination.
I was like, underwear and sneakers together. I don't know what it is. I've always loved it. And if you can match it.
Oh. Yeah. You know, I hadn't thought about that. I like the matchiness of wearing shoes and soccer, rugby socks and underwear. I haven't taken any pictures like that, but I am going to do it just for you. Because I have a pair that matches that pink underwear that I wore the other day on my last post with the socks. I have a pair of Adidas sneakers that are the same color. I don't know why I never wore them, but I'll put it on. I'll take a...
We'll have to use that for the cover art.
Oh, right on.
That can be the cover art picture. Oh, my God. Okay.
I will take it just for you. Just for you. Hashtag you.
Hashtag podcast. Yeah. So all my secrets are coming out. Well, it's a podcast. They all come out anyway.
Right. But eventually.
Yeah. Well, everything we're planning, if you don't know me by now, you'll know all of me next year. So, which is, you know, fun to talk about, which.
Yeah.
A friend asked me the other day, it's like, you really put yourself out there. Are you okay with that? And I'm like, yeah, I'm okay with that. I'm having fun. I'm like, obviously boys are liking it. And because I get a lot of feedback and people tell me I'm doing a good job. So we've had one negative comment about the podcast that I know about. And like I tell everyone, hey, you can't all be winners. You can't have everyone love you. So you got to have somebody. So, you know,
there's always going to be somebody. So in the spirit of you putting yourself out there, what are your favorite brands and cuts at the moment?
Oh, you're turning it back on me.
I am turning it back on you.
I'm a big bikini fan. I love bikinis. I have since I was 12 years old and got my first pair. Once I got them, I was like, oh my God, where have these been? I told this in my brief tale. If you go way back in the podcast, you can hear it. Andy actually interviewed me for it. Because I turned the tables and I'm like, all right, Andy, interview me. And it was a jockey brand called Scants. And it was 100% nylon.
Amazing.
And it was red and it was kind of higher cut and it sort of had a pouch, but it didn't. And the sad thing about the pair is, like women's nylons, they got to run down the front. So it felt like your business was stuck in a cheese grater because you sort of poked through and it was just like, and they stopped making them. So I couldn't get them anymore and almost cried. I love this pair. And so now I love Cock Socks is one of my favorites.
Oh, yes. Yes. I forgot to mention them.
I love them. I love their bikinis. I love just about everything they do. I even love their long johns. That tells you how good they are.
Yep. I have two pairs of those. Yep.
So I love those. Mm-hmm. I love Ergo Wear. They are a good
brand. Sorry to interrupt you, but I have to comment on this. I love their stuff, but in the last year, I've been so disappointed with them because their sizing has changed.
Yes.
And now their smalls, their smalls are a little bit medium. And they're also, again, going back to that 90s fit where the pouch is a lot longer. So then when you're trying to put them on, the seat in the back goes up your butt. And I was so disappointed that I sent them an image. I sent them an email with lots of pictures comparing it to their older versions, and I never heard back from them. I'm sure they were totally annoyed by me, but because I've been buying them since 2010, I thought, you know, I was just really disappointed. But go ahead. I'm sorry. So Ergo Wear is another brand that you like.
Ergo Wear, end to end, of course, is high on the list, which every man has that on his list. I never knew how to say it. Sucrew out of the UK. Love them. Love their pouches.
Question about that. Because I have a couple pairs and the thongs are the only thing that fit my cock easily. The other ones, like they feel like they're smushed, like your parts are smushed and they go down. Like I can't get a nice fit on those. It's like everything is so smushed.
I don't have that problem. Mine has been some of the backs in them because I don't have a butt, which I'm so upset about to this day. Friends are like, do squats. And I'm like, I don't care how many squats I do. I'm never going to have the butt I want. But it's the back was kind of fit funny, but it depends on the pair. Let's see. Who else do I like? Who else do I love? Greg Home, of course. Mm-hmm. Is one of the top ones. I don't have as much as I want, but you know,
they're expensive,
but they're so good. Like the Torrid lines, when you get them, and you open it and you see this little itty bitty brief or thong, and you're like, "What the hell is it?" And they're like, "No," and then you put it on, and you're like, "Holy shit!"
I know. They weigh less than a snowflake, but they can hold on to so much.
It's like that pouch. I'm like, good Lord.
It's amazing.
So that's one of my favorites. Mm-hmm. And let's get through I'm going through my mind. I have so many that change. And one brand I need to buy more of, I haven't tried in a while, that I really did like was Wild Man Tea out of Miami.
Oh, yeah. I've seen them. I don't have like a 12-incher to wear those, but I've seen myself.
He had some that are normal, but I got two pair of his. One was, they were sort of they're many years ago. They're a matching set, and I've got to find them. Where one was a white pouch with black mesh all the way around everywhere else, and the other was white with black mesh in the front in the pouch.
And did you fill the front end easily?
Yes.
Wow. Are you flirting with me now? You're telling me that you have a 12-incher?
I don't have that big, but you know.
But it's big.
But it fills out a pouch. I'm just saying.
Damn.
So impressed. I don't know where these went to because I have some underwear where it's just like, seriously, who is this made for? I'm I have a good bulge, but when I have extra fabric and I never have extra fabric, I'm like, something's going on here. I don't know what it is, but But I like those, and there's so many that come and go, and it's so hard to keep up with who's out there, who's not out there anymore.
There's too many, which is fantastic.
It comes and goes, and then, you know, we're trying to do Australian shows and brands, and that is like the land of underwear and swimwear. You can't keep up, so I'm farming that out to Australian boys to do for me. So,
ooh, I can't wait.
Oh, those accents. But they say they love American accents down there, so I'm ready to go. I'm like, come on, let's go.
You need to move down there.
Well, I have a friend who wants me to move down there, and I'm like, although one of my favorite TikTokers is from Georgia. He's gay, extremely country. I'm talking country gay. Hey, y'all. I have to send you his, and he's got to be late 20s, maybe early 30s, if that. He's super young. Young. He's got to be like 6'2 and thin. Okay. And he's always eating everything and lots of it. And I'm just like, I hate you, because I remember when I was just the same. I remember I could eat for days and not gain a pound. And now, nope. So he lives in Melbourne, Australia with his partner or husband, who I guess they moved from Atlanta there. So he's always going around Melbourne eating, showing the town, flying back. And I just love him because he's just like so country. And I'm like, you know, those people in Melbourne, Australia are going, what are you saying? Wait, because he's got that thick country accent. And it's like, they're going, what? So he is just so much fun to watch, because he's like him and his partner. Well, it's always him. You rarely see his partner, but like going to Thailand and going here and eating and going here and going. And I'm just like, I want your life.
Sounds amazing.
And he's at home because he went to the Buc-ee's up in, I think in Calhoun was his last video he posted a couple days ago, because he's home for Thanksgiving.
Well, I'm glad that there's ATL representation in Australia. We need some of that.
And I just stumbled across him, and he's like, I'm going home to Atlanta, y'all. And I'm going, oh my God, I love you. Oh my God, I love you. And I'm curious. I'm like, is your boyfriend just as country? I'm like, I want to know these things. And my friend in Australia, in Melbourne, I go, you need to make friends with him and find this out for me. And he's like, I am not doing that. I'm like, come on, go find him and make friends.
I mean, if he was eating in his underwear, that would be a great way for you to like reach out.
Well, he never shows underwear. He never shows.
Ah, there we go. Even if he did it once, that could never be your shows.
Nothing. Anytime he goes swimming, he's in shorts. And I'm like, you're in Australia where like the swim brief is like the thing. And you're...
Yeah. Well, I mean, if he's always eating, he might need the extra room. I know I do.
But he's my favorite. Oh my God. I just love him to death. And I'm like,
check him out.
I'll look him up and I'll send you the name.
Please do. Thank you.
Because he's just so adorable. And I just, I'm just like, oh, you're just so cute. So I guess we'll wrap it up there.
All right.
We're going to have you back on, because you have so much
sounds great
to talk about. Because we've gone for almost an hour. Ooh, we normally don't go over 20 minutes. So, we're here. So tell everyone.
It's brief tale, but I was going to say it's brief tale, but it ain't so brief.
It's not brief today. It's long today. So enjoy.
We like long. Totally like long.
We do. But this is a fun one. I think no one complains that we're too long, especially on these.
No.
They may complain on other shows, but these are just like, So tell everyone where they can find your amazing pictures online.
You can find me on Instagram at a guy named Jay, J-A-I.
Go follow him. You will not be disappointed. When he posts his pictures with his boyfriend, they look amazing, and you will be happy, and you will be a jealous bitch and go, look at those happy people looking amazing. I hate them. 'Cause they look incredible. And you get to see the socks, which I just love the socks. Oh my God.
Yeah. I realized that I have all these socks and I never wear them. So now I'm making it a point to wear them all the time.
I support that fully. I enjoy that. And they are just the perfect height too, which I like. So it's like collar socks. And I'm like,
oh. Right. So, oh, rugby socks. Oof.
Rugby socks.
Might be the next new obsession, but we'll try to keep that one on the DL.
Socks, sneakers, spandex. Oh, my list keeps growing every year. Right? I'm just like, oh, I can't afford this. So
it gets really expensive. Yeah.
Oh, underwear is tough enough.
And but if it makes you happy, that's at the end of the day, that's what counts.
Exactly. It makes me extremely happy. So
yeah, we're like Carrie Bradshaw's, minus the shoes, more underwear.
Exactly. We got underwear, more. So, all right, everyone, we'll wrap it up here. We will have Jay back on a show soon because I've already talked to him about next year. And part of that was to snag him into coming back on, which I think worked. Yippee! So follow UNBTM. Go fill out our survey for the podcast. Let us know what you love. If you really love us, go join our Patreon and help us support this. And, you know, enjoy the rest of the year. And we'll have a new podcast soon. Bye, everyone.
Bye, Tim.
Thanks for listening to our show. If you like what you hear, consider supporting us at Patreon at patreon.com/UNBblog. Follow us on social media. You can follow the blog at UNBblog on Twitter and Instagram. Read the blog at UNBblog.com. Also follow me if you like art or anything else fun in underwear at UNBTim on Instagram and also Twitter. Thanks for listening, and we'll have more podcasts at you very soon. Bye.